Dear friends, after the review is over, now let us switch on to the other topic, revision, which is envisaged in section 115 of the Code of Civil Procedure. So, section 115 deals with the revision. Revision means revise. So, once again, the same to you, look again and correct the errors if any. Go through carefully and correct wherever necessary. This is the definition or meaning of the so-called revision. Normally, please remember, revisions will be on the orders. A person aggrieved by an order passed by a court subordinate to the High Court. Orders, normal interlocutory orders, there are many stay orders, so status quo orders, injunctions, so many things will be there. So, definitely they can file a revision against such order. But the following facts are necessary. Their conditions, definitely there are. Because, please remember, revision is almost equal to a writ of certiorari. Of course, even though it is not 100% equal to certiorari, just like the tribunals and the High Court, it is almost on par with the writ of certiorari given by the High Courts. Right. Now, let us go through the provision. Section 115 deals with the so-called revision. The High Court may call for the record of any case decided by a subordinate court. Now, just like certiorari, they will call for the record when it appears, number one, that the subordinate court has exercised the jurisdiction which is not vested by law. That means jurisdictional error. Even though you do not have jurisdiction, the court has entertained the same. Second point, even though there is jurisdiction, the court has failed to exercise the jurisdiction. This is another part. There are certain judges where they will not exercise their powers. Number three, even though they have exercised the jurisdiction, this exercise is illegal, they have exercised it illegally, or there is some material irregularity. So, basing on these three conditions, normally we will file the revision petition and the court, High Court will ask for the records. So, that is not exercising the jurisdiction, exercise the jurisdiction even though he is not empowered. Exercising the jurisdiction illegally with material faults, definitely High Court can interfere and it can make an order as it thinks fit. Please remember, revision will not act as a stay because stay is separate. Stay orders are separate, so revision will not act as a stay. Normally, people will be under impression that where once the revision is allowed, stay is granted. No. Unless the High Court grants stay order, revision is just a revision. If the stay is there, it will continue. If it is not there, then you can go take further steps. Right? So, please remember, the revisional power of the court under 115 CRPC is clearly in the nature of writ of certiorari. Writ of certiorari. Of course, it is not as wide as a certiorari, as decided in the case of Major S.S. Khanna versus Brigadier F.J. Dhillon, 1964. I will tell you the observations of Justice Gajendra Ghatkar. Here, the revisional power of the High Court is very, very limited, I tell you. In the case of Panduranga Ramachandra Mandalik versus Maruti Ramachandra Ghatge, 1966, right? Justice Gajendra Ghatkar rightly propounded that while exercising the revisional jurisdiction under 115 CRPC, High Court is not competent to correct the errors of fact. Please remember, though the fact cannot be corrected, and unless the errors are the point of law has relation to the jurisdiction of the court, right? So to try the dispute itself, normally if necessary only, then the High Court will rectify. Otherwise, High Court will say whether he has acted over action, whether there is inaction, then they will enter the matter. Normally, they will enter the matter to some other court. This is what they do. But anyway, so normally, even in CRPC also, there is a provision regarding the so-called revision. So for example, if you file a petition for handing over the property which is seized in the police, if the district court did not give the order in your favor, you can go in revision. In revision, that is, please remember, a person aggrieved by an order passed by the subordinate court to the any high court, you can go to the high court and file a revision petition. But please remember, this is condition is, so the case must have been decided, the order must have been given. Without finalizing the issue, you cannot go for revision. This is another important point to observe, right? Thank you.